first one is your ECB. What is this? England Cricket Board. External commercial borrowing. Simple example, suppose for example, a company in India, ABC. ऐसे आपको समझ में आता है ना ABC XYZ? कि चले टेक द नेम ऑफ द कंपनी चलेगा. सो ABC इज अ डोमेस्टिक कंपनी, दैट इज इंडियन कंपनी. इफ दिस कंपनी वॉन्ट्स टू बोरो मनी फ्रॉम अब्रॉड, अब्रॉड मीन्स सपोज दिस इज यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका, विल बोरो फ्रॉम USA. हियर दिस ABC कंपनी विल नॉट एक्सप्लोर द areas of Indian stock market, Indian banking system, due to certain reasons. It depends on a particular company. They don't want to raise funds from Indian stock market. They want to raise funds from USA. It depends on a company. Now, what are the benefits if this company is borrowing from USA? It will get dollar. So what do you think? RBI will promote this activity or discourage this activity? Always promote this activity, because you will convert dollar into rupee. Because if you want to invest in India, borrowing from abroad, you cannot invest in dollar. So RBI's forex will go up, foreign exchange reserves that RBI is having. Then foreign exchange reserves will go up. What will happen? You will invest in terms of rupees. Now, what is the meaning of this commercial borrowing? Commercial means these are not borrowing by the government of India. Getting my point? These are not borrowing. These are, if there is a loan on a particular company, it doesn't mean that loan belongs to a sovereign debt. So this amount of dollar which are flowing into India is not the debt on Indian government. This is the debt on ABC company. This is the key here. If we borrow from World Bank or IMF, this comes under the category of sovereign debt, the debt on government of India. Getting my point? But these type of debts are on companies. External commercial borrowing. How this is different from the borrowing by the government from multilateral institutions as well as other countries. Now you can see the difference. Only difference is simple. The debt belongs to company, not on the sovereignty of our country. External commercial borrowing. So RBI will promote and they will raise fund. So they will invest in Indian economy. Now what happened? If RBI will get dollar, it is very easy to fund our CAD, current account deficit. So what do you think? RBI will promote more and more activities like ECB, because RBI is receiving dollar without any obligation. So if they are receiving these dollar, they are able to fund current account deficit. The current figure, $15 billion in Q1. This is the latest data, 2 days before. 15 billion. If we talk about July month only, July is different from Q1. You remember the discussion? We are entering into second quarter. So July, the figure, these are actual figures I am giving you, not hypothetical. $18 billion in July 2018. This is our current account deficit. It means whenever you will compare with Q1, you see the rise. Whenever you will calculate the Q2 data, you can see the difference. Because whatever you incurred in Q1, you've already incurred in 1 month of Q2. And it is expected to rise $19 billion in July and August. So August data will come around 20 days in September. Around 20th September, you will get the data. These data comes with a time lag of 15 to 20 days. So just to fund this deficit, RBI will get dollar without any obligation. Why? Because obligation is of the company, not of the government. So RBI will promote this, and RBI will always promote this. RBI will prefer that company should borrow from abroad. So we'll write this. External commercial borrowings. समझ आया ना आपको अच्छे से? Very, very important concepts. External commercial borrowing are the borrowings by the domestic company from abroad. Are the borrowings by the domestic company from abroad. Domestic company from abroad. Full stop. The obligation to repay on ECB is on the shoulders of a particular domestic company. A particular domestic company. Full stop. This is another. This is another important source of raising funds by the companies. Full stop. RBI with reference to India, or with reference to Indian economy, RBI with reference to Indian economy will encourage this activity because when company borrows under ECB, company receives money in terms of dollars, and to invest in India, they convert dollars into rupees, and these dollars go to RBI's foreign exchange reserves, and these dollars will go to RBI's foreign exchange reserves. Full stop. RBI can use these dollars to fund India's current account deficit. In bracket you can write example during 2013. RBI did the same thing. Okay? Example is during 2013. Last line, important line. The ECB is not the debt on India. That is, it is not the sovereign debt, this is the debt on a particular company. This is the debt on a particular company. This is the debt on a particular company. Full stop. Full stop. RBI will get dollars without any obligation. Without any obligation of debt. Any doubt you can ask. Any doubt if you have. External commercial borrowings. It depends on the funding. Capital account is the inflow under FIA and FDI. But ECB are the part of capital inflow. So it depends on the situation. Like for example, if there is a large capital flow for domestic investment. So obviously it is a part of capital account. But whenever we see in terms of debt, they are creating debt. And whenever you will create a debt obligation on India, then it comes under capital account. But these are the commercial borrowings for a particular company. So this is, when we discuss BOP, this will come under capital. But these are not the obligation. They are inflow of capital. So obviously comes under capital account. But these are not the obligation on India. Because it is on a particular company. There's also one risk that I'll discuss. That's why I'm again asking that if you have any doubt. Because there's one angle missing. That angle is risk of exchange rate. Like for example, understand the situation. We are having this much of current account deficit. And why we are having this current account deficit? Because of the value of rupee is keep on going down. Suppose for example, you borrowed last year at 64 rupees per dollar. Now suppose 2018 is the time to repay your ECB. The value of rupee is down, depreciates. So it means whatever you have borrowed, you have received less. Now at the time of repayment, you have to pay this 8 rupees per dollar. 8 rupees per dollar, you can imagine the huge amount when it converts into millions of dollars. Because obviously you will take loan in terms of millions of dollars. This is the most important risk under ECB. So if RBI wants to promote external commercial borrowing, first, the most important thing, RBI should stabilize exchange rate. Because you are promoting inflow. And when there is the problem of outflow, companies will struggle. And when the companies will struggle, obviously companies will come under debt. And that vicious circle, the stressed balance sheet of company debt, then they will not able to repay the loans of that particular bank. So again, the problem of NPA you can connect here. Are you able to understand the relationship? Someone? So that is why RBI is experiencing outflow. People are thinking that today 72, tomorrow if it becomes 74, it is better to repay now. Getting my point? So whenever you will experience outflow, so outflow will expedite. And this is the sentiments of the market. Sentiments can just repay as quick as possible. So that you will be able to save 2 rupees per dollar. So 10 rupees per dollar is better to pay at 8 rupees per dollar extra. Herd mentality se bahut effect hota hai. It's all about herd mentality. Because whenever you read newspaper, I think yesterday I got a call from a student from Bhopal. To wo newspaper 2-3 terms samajh nahi aa rahi thi. 72, 74 aisa tha. Aap logon to kal ka newspaper laya tha na mere paas, latest tha morning wala, wo parso ka tha shayad. पता नहीं, मैं मोबाइल में ही पढ़ता हूँ तो याद नहीं डेट, But in that, it was written that rupee will go 75, 74. So these are the sentiments. Because if you are the investor or if you are the borrower under ECB, you will be also reading newspaper. If newspapers, the expert are saying that rupee will depreciate again or it will go further down, what will happen? You will experience outflow of dollar. Outflow of dollar means pressure on rupee. Whenever you will find pressure on rupee, your imports will go up. And whenever your imports go up and exports are not enough. If a company is borrowing under external commercial borrowing, then there is a risk of exchange rate in the domestic economy, vis-a-vis dollar. Are you getting my point? And now what is the solution? Again, I'm asking you. What is the solution? Chal raha hai, on kiya. What is the solution? There are concept of arbitrage. Arbitrage are the individuals or the banks who play in the currency market. And they hedge their funds in the currency market. Like for example, I am the arbitrage and I'm expecting that a rupee will be between 72 and 74. So I'll take the risk of currency fluctuation and will give ECB at fixed amount, rupee versus dollar. So the gain of arbitrage, if we compare, if rupee depreciates, there will be loss to arbitrage. If rupee appreciates, there will be gain for arbitrage. But companies are able to hedge against the currency risk. Getting my point? Hedge means protection against the currency risk. Shall I explain again? They will offer you fixed. They will, outsiders, they will offer you. Suppose there is an institute. So institution that will give you arbitrage facility. Arbitrage are the persons or the institution that play with the currency market. So they will offer you a fixed exchange rate. Suppose, for example, if according to my analysis, if I am a arbitrage, according to my analysis, rupee will fluctuate between 72 to 76. So, but there is a high risk of rupee depreciation. So we'll fix a deal at 75. Current wo laga do darwaza. We'll fix a deal at 75. So whenever you will fix the deal at 75, if a rupee depreciates to 76, 77, 78, then there is a risk for arbitrage, not the risk for the company. But if rupee appreciates, suppose for example 72, 71, then who will gain? Arbitrage will gain. But companies are able to hedge against the risk. Hedge means protection. H-E-D-G-E. Hedging. So hedge against the risk. So these arbitrage can play in the currency market. That will provide hedge for the risk of exchange rates. It depends on the negotiations. According to arbitrage, suppose for example, if I'll say rupee is 72, which is if I'll ask, choose one option, which one is possible in the near future? 70 rupees a dollar or 74 rupees a dollar? According to the current situation, which is the biggest possibility? 70 or 74? 74. It means you are observing a downward trend. So we'll experience or you will expect that rupee will depreciate in the future. So it depends on the value of rupee, the fluctuation in the rupee, and depending on the negotiation between the company and the arbitrage. Hedge funds. hedge funds against the risk of currency, against the risk of market as well. But here the concept belongs to arbitrage. Arbitrage are the players who play in the currency market. पहले बहुत होता था, now the business is down because of the internet. First, what happened previously, previous to the internet boom, arbitrage were buying Japanese yen from Japan. At this, they were selling in America. But due to internet and faster communication, their margin is shrinking. So margin of profit is around 0.1, 0.2 sometimes. Previously, they were getting rupee versus dollar around 2 rupees, 3 rupees because of the delay in the communication. But due to internet and this screen-based trading, the margin has been shrinking. We will write the last line. To mitigate the risk of exchange rate, companies can hedge their funds. Companies can hedge their funds with the help of arbitrage. Shall I write the spelling? Companies can hedge their fund with the help of arbitrage. This is hedge and this is arbitrage. Any doubt regarding this? So now it is possible to mitigate the risk. Then you will promote what? External commercial borrowings. Okay. Yes, please. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Important concept. Question may come in preliminary because of the two important factors: increasing current account deficit and rupee depreciation. So question may expect it. Dhyan rakhna. Hedging can come, arbitrage can come. So write one more line. What is arbitrage? Arbitrage are the players who play with the fluctuations in the currency market.